guys, and welcome to day 17 of your fossil advent calendar. So for today's episode, I thought I would talk about amber. Now, I thought it would follow on quite nicely from yesterday's video talking all about plants, because amber, it's formed from trees. So it's actually tree sap. So once it's expelled from a tree, it then hardens under heat and pressure and eventually forms the semi-precious stone or substance we know as amber. Now, what's interesting about amber is what it can encapsulate on its way down from the tree. So it's kind of like a resin. So as it's coming out of the tree, if there's an insect there, it's going to just trap that in time. But it can also trap any kind of small organisms or creatures. And so it's really, they're spectacular fossils because they are perfectly preserved. They have not altered at all. They are just encapsulated. And there you go, a lovely little parcel of time. So they could encapsulate lizards and like small little reptiles. And they can also, I think there was evidence of a dinosaur, a very small one, like the head of one. I might be mistaken there, I'll have to do my research on that one. But commonly there's lots of insects that have been encapsulated. And so they're really spectacular to look at, I think. And I love the stone itself, and that's obviously amazing on its own. But the fossils within, they're key. So amber first came about in trees from about 320 million years ago during the Carboniferous period. Sorry, my pronunciation, I'm just like missing out letters. No, the Carboniferous period. So quite a while ago, but in terms of plant evolution, kind of in the middle. So we have some really nice specimens. So I'm going to show you a few now of like the key ones with lovely insects inside, because I think the ones with the fossils in, they're the best. I might be biased, but let's go take a look. So I thought I'd start by showing you guys some of the smaller organisms that have been trapped in amber before. So the most common are the insects, so we can get mosquitoes and other small creatures trapped within the sap and the resin. Larger creatures are a lot rarer because the sap and the resin coming out of the trees, it's not in humongous quantities, so to trap a larger creature is much rarer. But we can get parts of larger organisms. For instance, here is the head of a lizard. I saw this specimen and I thought it was really amazing, so I had to share. And then here we even have the skull of a dinosaur preserved. So this was a more recent study, so I believe this was found earlier this year in March, and it's the head of a tiny dinosaur. So it only measures about 15 millimeters across, but it's a really amazing find because I believe a few years ago they found the tail of a dinosaur, but this is the first skull, correct me if I'm wrong. But what's amazing is when it's trapped in amber or resin, it's preserved perfectly, so it can tell us a lot more about the morphology of dinosaurs than we previously known. So hopefully we'll find some larger specimens, but for now this will definitely do. So I hope you guys enjoyed. So that's all I got for you guys today. I really hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please like and subscribe for more. I'll link all my social media down below if you'd like to check any of that out. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you're really enjoying the series as much as I am. I'm loving making it. So thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you next time.